In this unit, we will talk about fractional coordinates. Fractional coordinates are a convenient way of specifying where the atoms are located in the unit cell. Fractional coordinates make use of the crystallographic system of coordinates, meaning that the lattice vectors are used as a basis, and the absolute numerical values of the lattice constants equals unity. This means are set to 1. So, the atomic site parameters are then given as a coordination triple x, y, z, and these coordination values are fractional amounts of the lattice constants a, b, and c. This is best illustrated by an example. Well, let's say we have an orthorhombic unit cell with these lattice parameters. Now, an atom of the crystal structure might be located at x equals 2.5 angstroms, y equals 10 angstroms, and z equals 7.5 angstroms. We can now draw the atom 1 according to these coordinates at the respective site within the unit cell. We go 2.5 angstroms in the A direction, 10 angstroms along the B direction, and finally 7.5 angstroms in the C direction. Oh, yes, we see, interestingly, atom 1 is precisely located at the center of this orthorhombic unit cell. This result would also be clear if we had compared the atomic site parameters, the absolute ones, with the lattice constants. They are all exactly the half of the length of the lattice vectors a, b, and c. And this is exactly the way fractional coordinates work. We divide the absolute coordinate values by the unit cell constants, and what we get are relative or fractional coordinates. The advantage of using fractional coordinates instead of absolute ones is that special positions are immediately recognized, as in this case here. If you see the fractional coordinate 0.5, 0.5, 0.5, you immediately know that this atom sits at the center of the cell. There are more such special positions. Atom 2 might be located in this example at x equals 5 angstroms, y equals 10 angstroms, and z equals 0 angstroms. In terms of fractional coordinates, this is 1, 0.5, and 0. And we see this is in the middle of an edge, here at the edge along B. And a last example, atom 3 might be located at 0, 20, and 7.5 angstroms in terms of absolute coordinates. This corresponds to the fractional coordinates 0.5, 1, and 0.5. And this is located over here. Ah, yes, this is right in the center of a face. Here in the center of the B face, spanned by the lattice vectors A and C. This concept can be generalized, and this is shown here in an overview. Any coordination triple in which we have only zeros or ones must correspond to an atom at the corner of the unit cell. A coordination triple in which we have 2 times 1 half, regardless at which position within the triple, and a further 1 or 0, then the atom is located at the center of a face. If you have only 1 time a half and the other values are 1 or 0, then the atom sits at the middle of an edge. And vice versa, if the coordination triple has no special values, such as 0, 1, half, and so on, then the atom is on a so-called general position inside the unit cell. So, let's have a look at a real-world example. This is a sample of calcanthite, copper sulfate with 5 water molecules. It crystallizes in the triclinic crystal system, and the unit cell parameters are as follows. This is the first set of parameters we need. The second set corresponds to the information where the atoms are located. We see that two of the atoms have special positions, namely the copper atoms, one being located at the center of the cell and the other in the middle of an edge. All other atoms have no special locations. Before the year 1990, it was common to publish and exchange crystal structures by the transmission of such tables, in which the atomic fractional coordinates are listed as shown here. Today, crystal structures are distributed and interchanged, of course, electronically in the form of so-called CIF files. CIF stands for crystallographic information file. We will discuss CIF files and software that allows to visualize crystal structures on the basis of these CIF files later on. For now, we want to explore another software called Vesta in order to look at crystal structures at the atomic level in 3D. In the next unit, we will provide a tutorial for this software that allows constructing crystal structures. For instance, by transferring this information given here into the program. So, stay tuned.